what I want to do with my film is that, you know, like The Sixth Sense, because the twist is so good for The Sixth Sense, but I want to kind of do the same thing with my project. So when you rewatch the movie, it still makes sense. You're like, oh my God, that twist still makes sense at the end. But if, like, you know, your twist, you know, and you, it's good, but then you watch it again, it doesn't make sense at all. Like, the, what's the point of the twist, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So
there was a time that I was at his house, and I was trying to show him, like, he is not a fan of the old 70s type film. But what I know is they don't have the CGI kind of stuff.
Yeah.
So they have to put extra work into the story, extra work into the prosthetic effects. You know, the real, like, fake blood and, you know, all the kind of makeup dolls, all that kind of stuff. And so it was a film called Sleepaway Camp. The story was, it's you're at this camp.
Mm-hmm.
These kids play around and stuff and play games, but there's this killer on the camp killing people every now and then. A guy gets boiled, the water spilled on him. Oh, he's burning up and shit. There's a girl who has a hair burner.
Yeah.
Shoved up her.
That's just fucked.
Yeah. All these killers doing all these fucked up shit, and you realize the killer was this girl, and it turns out the girl was a guy the entire time.
Really?
At the very end, she's like, oh, "You were a guy?" Oh, and he's just holding up with a dead head on her hand. I was like, oh, like, it was just like, you know what I'm saying? Like, wait, so when she kissed,
was a guy,
oh, it was a guy the entire time. Killing all the
that's what I want to make. Like, so many people are just like, you know, what's a, you know, PG-13 get more views. I don't give a fuck. Like, I want to make, like, what I want for, like, a more mature audience. I'm not aiming for, you know, kids.
Yeah.
You know, you don't want to have a 5-year-old watching, you know, Final Lag, and you drill, you know, his face at the end. But that was what, like, you know, as he talks, like, there was not much, like, you know, CGI back then. But since I sucked so bad at After Effects and CGI back then.
You can't say that.
Whatever, before I sucked at it.
Yeah.
So everything was practical, even the blood at the end. I literally took a tube and then blew blood in his face and then bam, that's it.
But that's the thing, because I try to show him about the practical effects. Back in the day, that's all they used. Mm-hmm. So he can learn from them.
Yeah.
Because that's how Quentin Tarantino learned. He watched the old films because he knew that he did not know how to use practical effects. He did not know about CGI. That's why his films had so much blood and all that guts, because he didn't know how to fake it.
Yeah.
So he would literally give a guy a blood capsule. Yeah. He'll bite onto it.
Yeah, I literally had a blood capsule before. It tastes like shit.
It
oh,
does.
It's so bad.
But that makes it better, because your face is really yeah. Like.
What sparked me to do films is that when I was in grade 11, we had to do a sequel to 12 Angry Men, which was called The Final Lag, but that was like the first version that nobody ever called it. So like, we could either do, you know, a presentation or like, you know, what do you call it? Fucking,
PowerPoint?
PowerPoint, there you go. You could either do a PowerPoint, and then she's like, oh, you could also do a movie. I was like, what? I was like, yeah, bro, let's do a movie. And then it was actually his little brother, and then my other buddy, Eli, and then, like, I basically wrote all the script, and it was in my house. I, like, filmed everything. I actually acted in it. It was a freaking blast, but like now I look back at the original, maybe I'll send it one day, but I look back at the original, it's so bad, it's like you're laughing at it. 2 or 3 years later, I reshot it with, like, you know, a budget, with more experience and all that, and it actually made a good story. I know, like, you know, you wanted to make films, I was like, yeah, man, let's just do it, and then bam, we did it, but like, what made you do, like, you know, yes, I want to do films.
It'd be cool.
That's it?
I don't know. Like, I don't really remember why.
Yo, what about your channel? We didn't talk about your channel.
Oh, tell them about Kill Switch.
Yeah, Kill Switch Productions, bro.
Now you have a lot to say.
Yeah, buddy.
Go. It's great.
All right, go.
Well, I got a YouTube channel called Kill Switch Productions. And on that channel there, I just promote my airsoft life. You know, I have a GoPro that I run on the field, watches the gameplay I do, and with the footage I get from the games, I just cut it all off and make a video out of it.
And also you get your sponsors that sponsor you with the bullets for free.
Mm-hmm, yeah, I sponsored player. And
so if I wanted to reach you for Kill Switch Production, where would I reach you?
You go on YouTube, you go on the search bar, and you write in Kill Switch Production. And you should find
me. What about on Instagram or the other social medias?
Well, if you want to find me on Instagram, you'd have to look up Kill Switch Airsoft DW69.
It's actually pretty cool because when I watch his videos, like he actually goes like on a freaking Jeep and shoots people while the Jeep is running. And there's like smoke grenades everywhere. Like he's down, someone just pulls by his collar and then keeps shooting people. Or the latest video we actually got is like inside of like a bin, it's cool. And then you see like just a dark alleyway and they have flashlight and strobe light and you see like shootings everywhere. It's freaking awesome.
All right, well, what about your channel? What do you do on your channel, Oliver?
Oh, yeah.
Well, the thing is, we don't, I don't always do, you know, stuff with CPO because, you know, we have our own life, we work and stuff like that. So when I do my own stuff, you know, if it's like, you know, either, you know, effects, you know, like bullets and everything or how to do green screen and whatnot, if when it's just by myself, then I'll put on ONE Production, which is on Facebook. And like my Facebook page, but if it's just like with all of us, that's definitely gonna go on CPO.
All I do is read books, trying to find stories and twists and all that kind of stuff. But like, I try to find different ways to contribute to this team and all that kind of stuff, because we need an edge, we need to be above our competition no matter what we do. You know, we need to find ways to be more unique, to be more creative, to be more outgoing and different kinds of ways to get people's eyes on our team. So what I try to do is try to read marketing, science, literature.
That's really
just keep us going forward.
Anyway, I have a question for you guys. What's your favorite horror movie? Phil, you start.
Oh, yeah, I don't even watch horror movies, so I don't even have
one. Bro, I made you watch Insidious.
Oh, yeah.
Actually, that was a pretty good movie. I like that.
Yeah, Insidious is good.
I don't really have a favorite horror movie. Like, they're all fucking scary. Like, I don't like that.
Really? You don't like that? I like I love the cinematography, especially with James Wan. Oh my god.
Yeah, James Wan, I could rattle up. Well, he does Insidious, so that's what
Okay.
Yeah. I was like, you were like, I don't know, but like, yeah, he does Insidious. I could, like, or Saw, if you saw Saw. But, I could rattle on different horror films, but I would say James Wan, he took all those and just. Because the one thing is, like, in the Western Hemisphere, we do lots of, like, gore shock horror. Oh, blood! Oh, he has a chainsaw! Oh, my God! But when it comes to the Eastern Hemisphere, like Japan and Asia and all kinds of stuff, they do an atmosphere. Right. So when you're sitting there, you're watching a film, you're getting like creeped out a bit. Mm-hmm. Like, why are they in this place? Why did it, like, I would say.
The thing, feeling in your gut.
Creep. Yeah, you're feeling your gut. Like, I would say, if not in Insidious, I would say Alien. Mm-hmm. Scared. Because it's not just like a shock, but it's just an uneasy feeling because they're in a ship and they're in tight corridors. And it's like,
oh my god, it could be there.
Yeah.
It could be there.
There's a scene where she's running through hallways for like 6 straight minutes. And you're on your edge, like, he's supposed to come.
What is he gonna pop out? He's gonna pop out now.
No. And it's just like, it's just her, a gun, running through corridors, and you just hear, burr. But yeah, it's funny, but the whole time, you're just like, they're not showing this. Without it popping up. And you're just sitting there waiting. And I'm sitting there. And another great horror film, The Thing.
Oh, I haven't seen
it. Because you brought up The Thing, but I'm just serious. The best effects, prosthetic effects, it holds up still to this day. Mm. It was just amazing to watch The Thing. Because they're actually cold in the rooms and stuff. And this monster that kills you. Mm-hmm. And once it kills you, it takes over your likeness of the body. So the whole film, you have to judge how people act.
Yeah.
The words they say, Because you're like, so some guy will say, it couldn't be me. I was in Hall 1. Mm-hmm. Wait, I just saw you at Hall 3. Yeah, but I was out, and there's always kind of things going on. You gotta follow what people saying.
Like that. Yeah.
It's like a psychology kind of stuff.
Yeah, it makes you think. It's like, oh, wait,
but. Yeah, and when the monster arrives, the bad prosthetic effects and all that kind of stuff, and the blooding is just amazing. Just, I appreciate the hard work that they go through.
Me's actually, the recent film I'm watching in the theaters is actually called The Gift. Oh my god, the twist at the end was. Freaking awesome. It's like, you know, you don't know who's the bad guy at the end and it totally switches at the end. Like, oh my god. Like, I love films that makes you go like, oh my god.
Yeah, mind-blowing.
And then you have shivers at the end. That's like what almost like started, you know, make me do films sort of thing.
So Phil, like what film just freaked you out the most?
Or shivers, or like inspired you? Or
I guess it'd be the creepy films. Those are the ones that really get to me.
Yeah.
No, that creep like.
Do you have one like specific? Like you just like on top of your head it's like out.
Well, I guess yeah, because I remember the one scene where I think it was the first one. See him outside, he was walking by or something like that.
Okay.
And then boom, there he was inside the room. And I was like, oh my god, that is so fucking scary.
Yeah.
Cause like imagine being that person there, you know, you're just looking out the window and someone passes by. Oh, passes by again. Boom, he's in your fucking room.
Yeah.
Oh, shit, my pants.
Yeah. It like zooms in on his fucking face. It's like,
oh, yeah, man.
There's a time in, what's it called? In Sin City 3. Yeah, in Sin City 3. The one with the little girl.
Yeah.
The ending. Mm-hmm. Where you just saw the face in the darkness.
That's
the face was sitting there. You see it in Sin City 3?
Yeah.
You see the face in the darkness? And we knew what it was.
But it just freaks you right out.
Yeah, I'm like, oh my god, it's right there. And then she's just looking there, and the dog's barking at it, and she in the face just goes,
the music, I really found the music.
And not like even the shock things, it's the subtle things. Like when she looks and see the face just go.
Oh, yeah.
We know it's fake, but it's fucking weird. It's going like, and it's just like, you know, I love films where, when it's done, when you watch it at home, you shut off the lights. Now I gotta go in my room. I'm running to my room. Because back then I had a VHS, so I had to like, go from the basement all the way up to my room.
Yeah, but what was your favorite movie this year, or, you know, the past year?
Star Wars. Hands down, that movie was awesome.
A Jedi.
Star Wars, but
okay,
I will give an honorable mention because I love Star Wars, so I'll just give it the nod. But I would have to say.
Wait, let me say it before you say it.
Because it's now 2000. Wait, okay, go.
Yeah, because you already said your movie. My movie would be The Revenant because they used natural light. And it was actually minus 40 degrees. And if I be honest, I'd be like, fuck that, I'm going home, So...
Not dedicated enough.
No, but like, honestly, like, even Leonardo got like a few, like, flus just because he was on set, so...
That movie, yeah. That's the one where he's like, on his own.
Yeah.
And, like, he slept naked in a dead horse. He got attacked by a bear.
Yeah, he got raped by a bear. Yeah.
Not raped, it's not true, he didn't get raped, he just got attacked.
Finger speech. Okay.
People
say probably that. A baby bear inside of him.
But I would have to say, I say Star Wars with him, just because I love Star Wars so much.